there are some pretty big gaps in the world of system engineering. Let's say I've been hired as an engineer to design something. Maybe it's an information kiosk or some kind of specialized digital signage. Obviously, I need some kind of computer, right? But I'm not going to be one of those non-engineers who duct tapes a laptop to the back of a monitor and calls it a day. But on the flip side, I don't want to have to design a custom computer for every job I take. No client wants to pay for that, and it's a massive case of reinventing the wheel. Hey, look at this nifty computer I designed specifically so you could have your industrial-grade digital sign. So, what can we do that gives us a pre-engineered computing platform without the obvious problems with that first, solution I mentioned? Well, luckily, Intel has our backs. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. My guest is Kristin Brown from the Intel System Product Group, who is going to talk with us about Intel's next unit of computing, or NUC, line of small form factor, bare-bone computer kits and elements that are pre-engineered and proven solutions that will give us the computing power we need for our next project in a robust form factor, and all without requiring us to design a machine from scratch. Phew. And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about the Intel NUC Elements U-Series. Hi, Kristin. Thank you so much for joining me.
Hey, Amelia, thank you for the opportunity.
Okay, so first, Kristin, you work for a group at Intel that has a very unique charter. So can you tell us a little bit about the Systems Product Group at Intel?
Sure, let me tell you a bit about the Systems Products Group's mission and strategy. Its objectives is to drive growth by creating and delivering compelling and innovative products. We really want to help drive scale, credibility, and capabilities to the underserved and growing segments. We do that in two ways. One is by accelerating innovation within the channel, giving them building blocks to go and create the products that they think the market needs and helping them to reach the market that is underserved today. The other area that we focus on is bringing HVM credibility. So we envision things that perhaps others haven't before. Some of those may be things like small form factor workstations. So how do you get to a less than 5 liter workstation? Or how do you create a rugged product that is built upon compute elements versus having a soldered down compute solution? We also play in how do we bring channel opportunities for notebooks and other places that we feel are underserved by other companies.
Okay, cool. So as part of your group's innovation charter, you guys just launched a brand new line of products to enable modular and scalable designs. So what's your vision for this new line of products, and why do you think this new compute approach is so revolutionary?
Thank you for asking. One of the things that we felt we were seeing in the channel was a challenge of keeping up with the cadence of new CPUs and having to create new boards around those and then being able to bring that product to a solution. And we wanted to do something to help the channel to be able to kind of start in the middle, if you will. And so around that concept, we created a product called the Compute Element. You can see it's small and it's able to be plugged into different choices. So one of the things that we felt would help the channel would be to have different elements to plug into. So we said, hey, if I was a customer, how would I make this easier? And we felt giving them building blocks, such as a compute element board, rugged board, or entire chassis where the board is already put in and thermals have been validated, would help them to be more quick to market and take some of that R&D off their plate and give them more time to think about solutions and customer needs at the end.
So I would assume that you guys are bringing these elements to market, right? Are there other products and building blocks that you've also launched in this area?
Yeah, so we've launched a couple of different things in this area. So one is the boards themselves, which is you just take a board, you can add a chassis around it, a kiosk, or whatever the solution is you're trying to bring. We also brought along an assembly, so it's the board plus the thermal solution, and then you plug in your compute element to get a final solution. We've seen other partners come along and say, hey, I can take that pro assembly and I can create my own solution around it. And some of the different places that people are seeing opportunities have been even a surprise to us and really fun to be a part of their journey as well.
Okay, Kristin, so can you tell me more about those building blocks you mentioned earlier? What exactly are they?
Sure. First, the primary building block is the NUC element. And customers can work around that element in whichever direction they want. So they can take boards from us, or they can actually create their own board that houses that element inside of it as well. It's a new way to really design and build a product around it, and it gives them that full modular solution. The really nice thing about it is it's a full range of U-Series processors, so you can choose a Celeron processor all the way up to an i7 vPro processor and put it into the same chassis. We've done a few process chassis ourselves, and we can talk about those in a minute, but it really some of the benefits for the customer is that just-in-time system building. So maybe they started down a design path of thinking that the customer was going to want an i3, but as they've continued to work to develop the final product with them, they've added new capabilities that they want to add. They could go up the stack and add an i5 even to the same chassis that they had started the process on. So I think right now we're in an example of where you might make a change. Say you started on a kiosk 6 months ago and you had one understanding of what you needed, but now as we've moved into the COVID age, maybe touch isn't an acceptable choice for that chassis anymore. Maybe you need to add gesture as well. So it's going to take more compute. That partner can quickly make a choice of, hey, I need to add gesture. I don't need to go back and restart everything around that design. I can just choose up the stack as far as what level of processing I need to take on that additional gesture capabilities. So it really shortens the timeline that folks need to put into their R&D, as well as reducing the amount of R&D required. It's also very upgradable and serviceable. So once you've designed that chassis or taken one of ours, you can just go in and upgrade every few years that compute element piece, which has the memory, the CPU, the Wi-Fi, and the Bluetooth in it. So you're able to quickly develop an easy upgrade and serviceability process as well. And all of our products come with a 3-year product availability and warranty.
So, Kristin, this is part of an overall ecosystem, right? This is just a beginning step in the process.
That's right. So the NUC 8 Pro compute element is just one piece of the overall solution that we're making available to our partners. The next piece as a customer would be to choose which board really works for you. You may choose to take an existing board, and we've created smaller boards that have I/O ports that you can build out, as well as boards plus the assembly, which is where we add the thermal solution to the story. We've also created more rugged boards that have wattage flexibility capabilities that will really protect a system if there's a lot of thermal and power flexibility in the systems. And we've created 3 different solutions there. So expandable, which is basically we've given a space where you can add the I/O that you would like to add. Dual LAN, which we see as being an opportunity that folks may want to use for monitoring Ethernet traffic. And then a multi-HDMI, which allows for folks to have 6 1080p displays running at the same time. This really allows for just-in-time system building because they can come and pick off-the-shelf solutions that we've already created, already validated, and then they can just put it into an existing kiosk that they want to load it into, or a robot, or whatever that experience is that they want it to. We've got a full range of processors, which covers the Celeron up to the i7 vPro, and it's really just a way for folks to innovate more quickly with lower cost of inventory as well, because you're able to choose the processor later in the process, because you can start with the board and then invest in the processor later once you truly understand what your customer is going to want.
Very cool. Now, Kristin, in addition to these modular element and building blocks, your group has also designed and launched element-based semi-finished goods. So can you tell me more about these products and where exactly you'd see them being used?
Sure. We first envisioned what to do with elements. We also wanted to give customers something that they could buy that was a little bit more in the traditional NUC concept of, you know, hey, everything but the storage and OS is available to you. And we felt that there was a really big opportunity to fit a solution that would work well for digital signage, edge analytic, harsher environments, restaurants and healthcare, which would value a fanless environment as well as an IP50, so dust resistant product. And so along those lines, we created Austin Beach, which is a little bit more of a traditional NUC. And there were 3 versions of that. aligned with the three versions of boards that we talked about a second ago, but now adding that chassis that gives them the IP50 dust resistance, the CEC on every HDMI port, and delayed AC start, and that DC transient voltage suppression, and display emulation, which is pretty cool. In case of something going down, it will actually bring back up the image so that you don't lose that digital signage experience that folks are obviously paying to have advertisement or information that customers need to have. And one of the great things with Intel is we tested 24/7 sustained operations as well. So you know that that sign's going to be working, and we guarantee it for 3 years with a 3-year product life cycle.
Excellent. Now, as you guys build out your portfolio of these element-based products, will you also be addressing purpose-built products as well?
I'm glad you ask. And actually, one of the things that's kind of fun about the elements is we realized that we wanted to go deeper into the collaboration market. And so we said to ourselves, we want to create a part that really works well for the collaboration, the conference room, the education world. And we kind of looked at our own compute elements and said, you know, we actually have an opportunity here to take our vision and do it ourselves. We actually went and looked at our choices and pulled one of the boards that we had created for the Austin Beach solution and created the Fort Beach solution that you see here. So we took a board, we took a compute element, and then we added a chassis ourselves and created this product that's super purpose-built for the conference room collaboration experience. We realized that one of the places that companies get value was from video capture and audio, and so we added that capability in as well, and were able to launch a product for a significantly lower R&D investment, as well as a shorter time to market than what we would have had if we'd started from scratch, and were able to bring a very purpose-built, very specific product to market.
Okay, so Kristin, at the beginning of this Chalk Talk, you mentioned that the vision here was to build out an extensive ecosystem around this Element U series. Can you tell me more about that?
Yeah, definitely. So as I mentioned earlier, the first piece to our vision was to create the building blocks, which is the elements piece of it. And the second piece was to create the Intel options, so the rugged chassis element solutions. And one of the things that as we worked through it, we realized, hey, we could also do things like Fort Beach, which are very purpose-built. But we also felt like doing all those things ourselves really neglected to meet one of our charters, which is really to innovate and allow innovation in the channel. And so we went and started partnering with different channel customers who could bring different innovation to the market that we might not have had the acumen or the capability to bring into the market. And one of our first partners was JPIK, who's bringing a notebook into the market, as well as Loop, who's bringing this really cool all-in-one into the market. And we've been partnering with other folks like Blujour to bring their versions of a fanless device into the market. And one of the cool things is they see markets that have different I/O requirements, and so they're able to really meet the market where it is with their solutions. We've also seen other fun solutions coming in from folks like Solidier, who are doing projectors, and Kihi Tech, who's doing keyboards. And then we've partnered with Maddie G, who's creating both notebooks as well as an OPS, which we're really excited to be seeing them bring to market later this year, to really help different places in the market to bring up what they need to meet their solutions.
Now, Kristin, are all of these products available today?
Most of them are, or will be out in Q3, Q4 of this year. For more information, we would definitely send you guys to our ecosystem catalog, which has all of the partners' products and timing and key contacts in order to find out where they are. For our products, they're through our standard distributors, and all of the Austin Beach is in market today. All of the element building blocks that we talk about are in market today, and the Fort Beach is coming out later this month. So those are all generally in market already. Yeah.
Excellent. So if I'm ready to get started, Kristin, where should I go for more information?
So there's a couple of different places. One, I would definitely send you to Mouser's website to understand what they're doing with the U-Series elements. I'd also send you to the intel.com NUC assets if you need marketing collaterals. The intel.com/NUC website if you just want to really understand what are some of the use cases and places that we've seen the products have an interest for folks. And then finally to the ecosystem catalog, which can also be found at that intel.com/NUC website to see what the different parties are bringing to market, because we'll continue to see new third parties coming out with new products. That page that I showed you before is just a start. It's amazing the amount of interest that's out there in the market, and we're super excited to see it.
Excellent. Well, I think that's all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me, Kristin.
Thank you, Amelia.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about this topic from Intel. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/eejournal.